assistant chief with the Louisville Metro Police Department. Last August, LMPD committed to moving forward with increased transparency and improved efficiency in investigating officer-involved shootings. This most notably included a promise to release body-worn camera footage within 10 business days of the incident. This is not changing, but we are enhancing our method of delivery of that presentation. The following steps have been and will continue to be a part of our commitment and in process. Shortly after the incident, the chief or a member of the executive staff will provide a media briefing of preliminary information and address any public safety concerns on scene. Timely information will also be provided on LMPD's social media platforms to keep the public informed. Within 24 and 72 hours of the incident, involved officers will be identified to include current assignment, department photo, and commendations or disciplinary history. Identifications of involved deceased subjects will occur via the coroner per state law. Within 10 business days, body-worn camera footage will be released with a video introduction and explanation of our investigative processes. Criminal and administrative investigations will continue on all involved, including officers. Consultation with the Commonwealth Attorney's Office and applicable presentations to the grand jury will also occur. A copy of the case file will be provided to the Kentucky State Police for a thorough investigative review. A copy will also be provided to the Louisville Office of Inspector General in compliance with LMPD's existing memorandum of understanding. Our goal is to provide the community and our officers with a clear understanding of the process and a consistent format to make as much information public as possible, all while protecting the integrity of the ongoing criminal and administrative investigations. In many cases, at this 10 business day mark, there are still witnesses, both officers and civilians, needing to be interviewed and other evidence awaiting collection or processing. It is important to be cautious to not inadvertently release information that may taint future statements or investigations. To streamline communication and expectations, we have developed a standardized and curated video package we will be using moving forward when releasing body-worn camera footage of officer-involved shootings. Each curated video will include a detailed description of the incident, body-worn camera footage of involved officers, the identification of the involved officers and the subject, and an explanation of LMPD policy, equipment, and the investigative processes. When available, if appropriate for added context, and if it will not hinder the ongoing investigations, the video may also include dispatch radio traffic, 911 calls, scene photos, other surveillance videos, and any other information or evidence that may be available for public release. Going forward, this will be how we release body-worn camera footage for officer-involved shootings. There will not necessarily always be an accompanying press conference. Examples of when it may be necessary to call a press conference may include when there is a public safety concern, when we need the public's assistance with information, when there is a mass shooting or a mass casualty incident, or when the situation otherwise merits the need to communicate critical information to the public.